Good afternoon, all of you. Let us start our today's class. Today we are going to discuss the few reactions of the metal activity series. We will compare the reactions of the metals in the activity series, and then we are going discussing the exothermic and endothermic reaction. So let's start. Few reactions which were left, that is from metal activity series. So as we know, we have potassium, then sodium, calcium. So reaction with acid, this we will do. So sodium and potassium and sodium, these two will react vigorously with dilute acid to produce hydrogen. So reacts strongly, vigorously with acid to produce hydrogen. For calcium also, this two is for potassium and sodium, and for calcium will react moderately with acid to produce hydrogen. Okay, next we have magnesium. In the activity series, we have magnesium, aluminium, zinc, iron. Okay, magnesium, aluminium, zinc and iron, this four also reacts with acid with but here, as we know, these four are having less reactivity than this three, potassium, calcium and sodium, so they will react moderately. Okay, the reaction will be not vigorous, but this four also with acid reacts moderately with acid to produce hydrogen gas. Okay, next we have lead. After this we have lead. Lead reacts with concentrated acid to produce hydrogen gas, whereas copper and mercury, after lead we have copper and mercury. Okay, here we have copper and mercury. Lead reacts with strong acid, with concentrated acid, not strong, with concentrated acid it will react to produce hydrogen. Whereas copper and mercury, these two will not react with acid. Okay, and after that we have gold, silver, platinum. They don't react with acid, okay, to produce hydrogen. They do not react with dilute acid to produce hydrogen. Okay, so this was the comparison between the comparison of the metals, okay, regarding the reaction with acid. So first three, potassium, sodium and calcium, they react vigorously with acid to produce hydrogen, whereas magnesium, aluminium, zinc and iron, they react moderately to produce hydrogen, react moderately with acid to produce hydrogen. And next we have lead, which will react with concentrated acid to produce hydrogen. But copper and lead, but copper and mercury, they do not react with dilute acid. And next we have silver, gold and platinum, they don't react with dilute acid. So this was the reaction of this was the comparison between the acids regard comparison between the metals, the activity series regarding their reaction with acid. Now we have few more reactions which will show that the by using the activity series, metal activity series, we can compare between the metals. We can compare the activity of the metals. So the reaction which we have, that is zinc with copper sulfate, this already we have discussed, zinc plus copper sulfate. As in the activity series, zinc is in the zinc is at higher level, or zinc is more active, placed in a higher position than copper. That means zinc is more reactive than copper. So zinc will displace copper in this mixture, in this solution, and it will produce zinc sulfate ZnSO4 along with copper. Okay, so this reaction we are going to get. So here the blue color of copper sulfate, it will change to colorless zinc sulfate. Okay, and along with that red deposition of copper we can get. So this is next, we have the reaction between magnesium and ferrous sulfate, FeSO4. Okay, so here also, as we know, magnesium is placed at top at higher position than copper, than iron. That means magnesium is more reactive than iron, so magnesium will displace iron from its compound ferrous sulfate, and it will produce MgSO4, magnesium sulfate, and iron will be left out. So the light green color of the solution will change to colorless solution of magnesium sulfate. Okay, next we have, this is a well-known reaction to produce hydrogen gas, the reaction between zinc and H2SO4 or any acid, HCl also we can use here. So as zinc is at higher position than hydrogen, that means zinc can replace hydrogen from its compound. So we are going to have this reaction, zinc sulfate ZnSO4 plus hydrogen gas will be released here. This is a very useful reaction to produce hydrogen in laboratory. Next, for non-metals also, this can be done. That means if we take a compound of, this is a example of displacement reaction for non-metals, KI solution. Okay, potassium iodide. So in this, if we pass chlorine gas, then as chlorine is more active than iodine, so it will displace iodine from its compound. So we are going to get KCl, and iodine will be removed from this. Okay, so 2 KCl we are going to get, and iodine. So this is the displacement reaction of non-metals. Here potassium and iodine and chlorine, these two are the non-metals which will, one will displace by the other. So this was the reactions. Now we are going to classify the reactions according to the energy released into two groups. One is exothermic reaction, another is endothermic reaction. So exothermic and endothermic reaction. Type of chemical reactions we can say. So this is type of chemical reactions respect to the energy released. So suppose let us give an example. If hydrogen and oxygen reacts to produce water, H2O. Now here we have bond between two hydrogen atoms, we have bond between two oxygen atom, and here we have the bond between oxygen and hydrogen. Now these are the reactants, this is the product. Now to get this product, first we have to break this bond there is the bond between two oxygen atom and the bond between two hydrogen atoms. Now, during the breaking of the bond, energy is absorbed. To break the bond, we have to provide energy, then only the bond will be broken. Okay, this so here we have to apply energy in any manner. In we can heat it, so or we can apply give light there, we can apply light there. So in any form of energy, we have to provide energy, then only the bond will break. And during the making of the bonds, see here, we are getting new bond between oxygen and hydrogen. So during the making of bond, energy will be released. Now, if the energy absorbed during the breaking of bond, is more, energy which is absorbed during the breaking of bond is more than the energy released during the making of bond. That means here, making of bond, then the reaction is called endothermic reaction. That means this energy is more, where energy is absorbed, that is more than the energy which is released. That means if we calculate the energy absorbed and the energy released, then energy absorbed is more. That means in whole of the reaction, energy is absorbed here. Energy is absorbed. That means as a whole, the reaction is a endothermic reaction, where energy is absorbed. But if we get the just the opposite thing, that means during the formation of the bond, if energy released is more than the energy absorbed during the breaking of bond, then the energy then as a whole, the energy is released. That means the reaction will be a exothermic reaction. So we have two kind of energy, two type of reactions on the basis of energy change. One is exothermic reaction and another is endothermic reaction. So two types are there. Number one, that is exothermic, reaction, where energy is released in the form of any form, we can say it may be heat or light or any other form of energy. So here energy is energy is released or energy is produced. Okay, example of this kind of reactions are when carbon is, if we burn carbon in presence of oxygen, we have carbon dioxide along with heat and light. Okay, so this is a very common example of exothermic reaction. The reaction of the respiration is a kind of exothermic reaction. Any other fuel, the burning of any type of fuel, petrol, diesel, kerosene, all these are exothermic reaction. Okay, so these are there. Another exothermic reaction is there, that is calcium oxide. Okay, this is quicklime. But if we add water in quicklime, we are going to get slaked lime, that is calcium hydroxide, CaOH whole 2. Okay, and along with tremendous heat will be released, and we will get the water which we have added, that will starts a boiling. Okay, so calcium oxide, this is quicklime. In this, if we add water, we are going to get slaked lime, that is calcium hydroxide, along with heat will be produced. So this is a kind of exothermic reaction. This is next, during the neutralization reaction, all type of neutralization reactions are exothermic reaction. So let us have a activity on this. If we have that is activity 8, which is there. For this, what we are going to do, in a beaker, neutralization reaction. Okay, so this is a kind of exothermic reaction. In a beaker, we are going to take a amount of 100 ml of base, 100 ml of suppose sodium hydroxide. If we take, okay, we will take 100 ml of sodium hydroxide, which will act as base. This we are taking in a solution of sodium hydroxide, we are taking in this beaker. Now here we are going to add few drop of indicator, that is phenolphthalein. Then the whole solution will turn pink. So this is the pink solution of sodium hydroxide, where indicator is added, phenolphthalein indicator is added. Now in this beaker, in this basic solution, we are going to add drop wise, we are going to add dilute sulfuric acid H2SO4, or HCl also we can add. So here it is taken sulfuric acid H2SO4 dilute. Okay, and dilute sulfuric acid we are going to add drop wise. Now we are continuously we will shake it. So drop wise we are adding this and we are shaking this solution. And when we will add this, we can see the pink color is just where the drop is falling. At that point, the pink color will disappear and we are going to get a colorless solution. Okay, at that point, again, it will turn to pink. Now, we are going to continue this process, and after a certain time and continuously, we are going to shake it. With a glass rod, we are going to start the solution. So when we will do that, after a certain time, when we are adding this H2SO4, adding this acid, we are going to get a certain point where the solution, the whole solution will turn colorless. The pink to colorless, this color change, pink to colorless. This change we are going to get. And that point is the neutralization point. Means at that point, the whole base is neutralized by the acid which we are adding. Okay. Now, this is the neutralization point. And at that point, if you hold the beaker with your hand, then you can feel that heat has been produced. Okay. It is the temperature of this beaker is more than earlier it was. That means here heat is released, heat is produced. So this is, from this experiment, we can say that neutralization reaction is an exothermic reaction. Okay, all the neutralization reactions are exothermic reactions. So here, what reaction we are getting? Sodium hydroxide, is reacting with H2SO4, dilute sulfuric acid, and we are getting Na2SO4, sodium sulfate. So 2 NaOH we have to take, Na2SO4 along with water, H2O. Okay, so this is the reaction, and along with heat is produced here. Okay, so this is the this is the neutralization reaction. Here we have explained exothermic reaction. So up to this today, up to this only, next day we are going to do endothermic reaction, and we will discuss few examples of this. Okay, and in the same manner we will going to do some activity on this. So till then, do this, just read this chapter, and take very good care of yourself. Be safe. Thank you.